Glory to his holy name. He is good God. He is faithful. He is faithful. See, if we look at the situation, that situation can defeat us. If we look at the bigness of the situation, that bigness of the situation can defeat it. But if we just look at the bigness of our God, our God who we serve, he is bigger in any situation. You know, sometimes people say, well, why I have to go through that? We have to understand that we are in a spiritual warfare. We have a God who is the mighty, who is merciful, and who is the God of love. And we have a Satan who came to kill, steal, and destroy. This is his job, and he is real. Do not be fooled, he is real. But God gave us a power, he gave us the word of God. And the word of God says that we take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And we speak to this mountain, we speak the situation, and you will see that situation has to flee. Because the God's word says, submit to God. When we go and submit to him and we say, Lord, help me in this situation. So the first key is submit to God. The second is word of God says, resist the devil. You don't play with the devil. You don't look at how he destroy your family. You don't just see how he destroy your children or grandchildren. But you take the sword of the Spirit and you speak that situation. And you said, Satan, you must flee in Jesus' name. So the word of God says, submit to God, resist the devil, and he has to flee. I mean, he's not just gonna go, he has to flee. He has to obey the Spirit of the living God. And the Spirit of God, as you are a child of God, the Spirit of the living God is live in you. And the power of the living God is in you. The same power what raised Jesus Christ from the dead is in you. And we have to take that sword of the Spirit, which is the word of the living God, and we speak that situation. And it has to flee. That is the promise of our Father. Hallelujah. That is the good news. This is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the good news. Hallelujah. Well, I want to welcome you right now, and also we're going to open up in prayer. For those who is able to stand, please stand on your feet in the reverence of the Spirit of God. So, Father, we thank you and we praise you. We glorify your holy name. We thank you, Father, for who you are and for everything that you're able to do. Oh, Father, we thank you, Lord God, and we welcome Holy Spirit of the living God, welcome into this place. Touch the hearts and the lives of your people. Father, we thank you, Lord God, that the change, we're calling in change is coming to your people. In their lives, in their families, their children, their grand-grandchildren. We're calling for change. Father, we're asking you, Lord God, comfort your people's hearts today, this morning. Fill your people's hearts with your faith, because your word says that just should live by faith and not by sight. And we are your children. We live by faith and not by sight. We thank you for it, Father. Let your peace, Jehovah Shalom, peace. I speak peace over your people. We give you all the praise and all the honor in Jesus' mighty name. Amen to that. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, right now we're going to go in a praise and worship, and we have Brother Yuri. He will lead us to the praise and worship. So tune up and to go in a praise and worship. Amen.
Our Lord God, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by thy great power. Let us sing this morning with all our hearts, and let us sing to the Lord. Amen. As though it is a new song. Amen. Glory to God. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will sing. has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad.